Hi everyone, I'm Meredith Bernstein, an applications engineer here at Instron. Today we're looking at mounting load cells to your test frame. Specifically, we'll be discussing the ring and pin features on our 2580 and 2530 static load cells. To start with, I want to take a second to show what these load cells look like. On the table here, we've got two of our 2580 series load cells, a 2 kilonewton and 30 kilonewton. We've also got a 50 newton load cell from the 2530 series. As you can see, they look slightly different, but they all have the same general connection design. Looking at the top of the load cell, this is where it connects to your frame, we've got either 3 or 6 tapped holes around this ring, one larger one in the center, this precision machine ring here, and a pinhole on the edge. The center tapped hole is for our through bolt. This is the bolt that goes through the crosshead and secures the load cell to your frame. These smaller holes around this outer circle are for adapter plates that are used with quick change and piggyback adapters. These are two super useful adapters that we'll cover in future videos, but for now, you can check out the link to more info in the video description. Looking at the ring in the middle, on the 30 kilonewton cell, you can see the ring is raised, and on the 2 kilonewton cell, it's inset. Any cells 5 kilonewtons and under include this separate ring that goes into the inset. This part has been precision machined to ensure your load cell is correctly centered when you install it. Its purpose is to make sure you're able to install your load cell in the same place every time you use it. The last hole on the edge here is for our pin, which is super important for rotational alignment. Without it, you can see the load cell is able to spin. However, once we put the pin in and line it up with one of the pinholes on our frame, the load cell is fixed in place. There are multiple pinholes on the frame to accommodate orienting your fixtures at the appropriate angle for your setup, such as when you're using a video extensometer, which mounts off to the side here at a 30-degree angle. And that's a quick rundown of the ring and pin design on our 2580 and 2530 load cells. For more information, please check out some of our other YouTube videos, visit instron.com, or reach out with any questions. Thanks for watching.